Yeah, then we are sitting here with this jet engine things, and from that to this to that, we can take a look at all the parts, and we can make understanding how these engines work. And there is one thing wrong with two of this, and this is okay for now. But how small of a difference make this engine not work as they should? We can take a look at that. We can make an understanding with all these parts, and with this that is open, we can take piece by piece. You see here, if we have this, yeah, we can take this. Put there, like so. Yeah, and the beginning here is starter that works by this small Bendix that flies out when it engages, and there's an rubber O-ring, rubber seal that grabs on the nut on the compressor. That is the first stage. It looks something like that. And when the air is compressed, it goes into the diffuser, like so, and all the air, you see, this part is lying on top of this, so all the air that this is compressing is going through here. And when the air has been compressed and goes through here, it will be guided by this guide vanes in the diffuser that straighten up the air, and then it goes into the combustion chamber, and here is where all the magic happens. But regarding this compression of air, when you do that, the air will increase in density, and by doing that, you need energy. That is what the compressor wheel is doing, and that energy, of course, has to be heat. So already here you have a big difference in temperature, and I will guess about 300 degrees or something, 200-300 degrees Celsius. You have the same thing in turbo cars. That's why you have an intercooler to make the air cool again. So when it goes into here, you have that there. Here it is locked, and here is where the magic happens, because inside here you can see these tubes. Inside these tubes are the fuel nozzles that fuel come in here through this ring and the fuel is sprayed into these tubes, and you can see in the end there it's very clean. That's because about there is the hottest point. You can see the color on this side, and you can also see here where the temperature is at its most. That's why this is so difficult with these engines, because you want the flame to be inside this, not outside. So on this old engine we have the glow plug for starting the engine. It was mounted here, and about 4 or 5 flights you have to change this plug because it burns off when it's mounted there in the hottest point. So this was an upgrade we did on these engines. Move the plug forward to a cooler area, and here you have the stator, this one. It goes into the chamber like so. Now you can see they want to route the air again. This angle, because now they want that air to hit the turbine wheel here. At if you see here at this angle, to make it spin the correct the correct way. And behind there again we have this, the nozzle, and this is there to create thrust, because without this engine will not have any thrust. So in a turboprop, if you take that in comparison, they don't have this, because you don't want the engine to push. It's only pushing in another wheel to make the prop go round. So, and how do they do this to make this, all this to work? With a some computer thing. So this gets temperature from the engine, it gets RPM from the engine, and it also have built-in parameters to increase and decrease RPM comparison to the temperature and RPM from the RPM sensor. So but how does it work? That's so easy. It's very easy how this works, because you have this. That's the whole moving part of the engine. So when you suck in air here, you make a under pressure, then the air will be drawn in. That's the correct terminology. Yeah. All this happens here, and you compress the air, and it heats up, and it fires, and it expands, and it wants to go out, and it pushes on this. That's again drawing this. So it's very near. It's driving itself in a way, and it's just a fuel pump that puts air. No, not air. Fuel pump that sprays fuel into the nozzles. More fuel increases the fire. More heat will go out, and it draws in more air, and it works by itself like that. So what's wrong with these engines? Yeah. This is my first engine. No, my second engine. I bought this many years ago. And then it has run very much. So it's an old, good running engine. But I think you can see here that it's missing something. This guide vane is gone. Yeah, it's broken off. I think it's a design flaw here, because if you see, since we have a radius when you're milling this, the mill and the, it will stand like this and like this. So the inner part here is thinner than the outer part. Maybe it's that, I don't know. But anyhow, this engine is not working because of this. And this engine is not working because of that also. I have it here. And the engine starts and it runs. You can see if you look in the back of the engine while it's running, it's you see that something not correct. But when you try to throttle up, the magic inside here is not magic anymore. And all of this wants to go out there at the same time, so you have a flamethrower. And now you can see how sensitive these engines are. Just because of this, the air will go not on a straight line here, it will go like this, and it will destroy the airflow into the expansion chamber. And it's that delicate. So what I want to do, because this engine is out of the market now. We make engines, but this Merlin 160 is not produced anymore, and the parts are gone. We can try to make this run either way, because this is destroyed. So if I think I will try to cut this out, then we have a mounting screw, then we can put this in here with a mounting plate on the underside and a screw on the top, then it will never come loose. And I think that's the way to go. We will try this. And because this engine is an old gas start engine, this engine is the latest version with Kero start. So I want to try to make this engine run. And because there will be something white from there, all over there, with long wings and everything, that this will fit into. We will see. Yeah, now I have taped up and tried to close up the cooling passage to the bearings, and we can take a look at this bearing things, because this is like that, and inside here you have this groove, you have one there, and you have one there. These are passages into the bearing and front bearing, and it goes through to the back bearing, and back bearing is here, and the pressure from the combustion chamber forces air, and with the fuel, yeah, that's why we have oil in the fuel, through the between the shaft and the tube here, and through the bearings and out back. You can see the soot here from the fuel. And how did I do that? Yeah, they here you have the fuel into the engine, and there are fuel in, and it goes here through this there, and to the fuel nozzles, and and then through this tube with a restrictor, and this goes to there, into this, and into there. So and that goes in there to the bearing. Yeah, so what I was trying to say, through this you have compressed air through, so you have the fuel and compressed air through the bearings that will make a like a fog lubricated bearings. So when you store these engines, it's very important to think about this, because if you get dust in here, that dust will go and also straight into the bearings. So think about that when you store the engine or where you fly. That's then I will cut here, and I will also take with me the neighbor. The neighbor stator fin, or the guide vane. So I will take out this and the neighbor here, because it's so close here. I think that's wise to do, because I have a wiggle and look, and everyone is okay as far as I can see. So because you may be thinking now that you can fix this, but what about the next one that will fall off? Yeah. Then we try to cut out this. Finished with grinding and dremeling this to fit. So it's like so. Yeah. And I made this just this to so I can get the radius correct, because this will be the reinforcement on the back side here. Yeah, like that. On the back side. So we screw this screw this with one screw down there. Not easy with these round things that want to go everywhere. Screw one screw down there and one down there. Then I will I think it's room. I will see, but on the other side screw drill through here and thread this. Maybe that will not work, but I will yeah, we will see. Yeah, then I have thread this and countersunk this here. Now we mount this together, see what happens. Yeah, and we have screws that's too long. I think that's wise, because if they come loose, they cannot come loose and into the engine. That's a smart thing, I think. So, like that. Like so. Bit more here. So when this all this is in place, we also have a mounting screw on this loose part from the outside. So we will drill a hole in the housing for this. So yeah, I think this will work. Yeah, then we are finished with this. And can you tell? Yeah, it's there. And you turn this right this way. You see the reinforcement, and yeah, I'm happy with that. So now I will clean everything, and then I will flush out the bearing area, so I know there is not any metal debris there. Yeah, then we mount this together again. then everything is back together again under here. And I just changed this green shrink tube on the starter cord. I don't want green cords here. Yeah, so now it's just the covers and the nozzle, and we can try to start it.
Han går på tid, tenker jeg nå. Kjørte du som en vilje? Nei.
Hæ?
Kjørte du som en vilje?
Nei. Jeg bare lot den trekk så synt å se det ble varmt.
Ja. Kjemmer man ned for å kjøre før? Mhm. Ikke jævlig lang tid.
Ja, det er mye luft og mye gøyere.
When I flushed out this bearing area in the engine, I also lubricated it afterwards. That's why it was so much flames in the start, first start there. So I have to abort it and try again. So it will, because if you overheat this back part, the bearing can go south or something. Yeah. So, but on the second start, it started. So, and you see sparkles and everything, that's the turbine wheel freeing all the aluminium parts from this diffuser. So, yeah, and that this engine will be mounted in the new member of the family here, big glider. So we will make also a retractable up and down for this engine to that glider, and that will be a separate video. So, but I hope this will work, and we will find out. Yeah. So until next time. See you. Thank you for watching.